I've always wanted one of these. And now I have one. Thank you so much. I want to thank, of course, Scott and Shelley and all the team at Final Draft that even thought to do this for me. whether it's deserved or not. I mean, it could be that Final Draft has made a terrible mistake. But I'll go along with it. I want to thank Margaret and Q and Brian and Akiva, all those sweet-talking liars. I hope you guys know that they didn't believe any of this shit. Right? But thanks for trying. And I thank all my friends and family, my son Paul. there's an old Yiddish expression in English goes, there are those who love you, and then there are those who love you and show up. And so I want to thank all you show-ups for being here. And finally, of course, my dear, dear Mia. I love you. I love you with every breath of my being. You make it possible. All these kind words were said is so very nice. If it makes a difference, and I mean, if what I've done it makes a difference, and it seems to me that if you look carefully at the last 20 or more years, it seems to me that the writing is getting better. This year's Oscar nominees, last year's, last few years, and go through and find screenplay after screenplay, both original and adapted, that are deeper. I'm thinking films like Moonlight, Manchester by the Sea, on and on and on. Fences, of course, but that's August Wilson. He's always been great. And man, any number of them that the characters are rich now and more dimensional and subtler. And then, of course, there's the magnificent works of long-form television. And this is an art form that absolutely takes my breath away. Writers today, like Margaret and others, are creating what will be the cathedrals of the 21st century. These 100-hour masterpieces, we're going all the way back to The Wire and before and up to today. Great things like Black Mirror. I mean, do you see this thing? Jeez. Right? Where? I mean, the work is just wonderful. It's just great. And it seems to me that in the when things get the worst, the writing gets better. And in this world we live in now, is not, it's awful now. but it's been getting there for over 20 years. I mean, this is the payoff to 20 years worth of setups. Right? I'm going back to the super recession in 2008, and then the Iraq War, and then 9/11, going all the way back to the Clinton scandals. There's been 20 years building where things are just getting worse. And during that 20 years, the writing has just gotten better and better and better. And there's got to be a relationship between those two things somehow. I mean, Breaking Bad was born in the year 2008, the same year of the recession. And it's about a criminal entrepreneur. And so I'm encouraged. I mean, there's two ways to look at these things. I mean, every morning, I don't know about you guys, but every morning, I, in some sort of masochistic ritual, read the New York Times. And my gut just turns into this fist of a knot, right? That's one way to look at it. The other way to look at it is its subject matter. For satire, I mean, SNL has never been better, right? Okay. House of Cards, I mean, they're made now. I mean, and so it's subject matter. You don't have to write about the politics per se, but these politics are going to affect families. They're going to affect everybody down to their soul. And therefore, it's a chance to take inspiration from this terrible crisis and the world we're living in general, and use it as a spur to write something that really tears open the human heart and shows us in ways we've never seen before what it is to be a human being. they quoted me there how important all of this is, of course, because when the opposite is true, when the storytelling goes bad in a society, the result is decadence. Well, I didn't say that. I'm quoting John Howard Lawson, who said that in 1936. Right? And John Howard Lawson, you may not know, was the founder of the Writers Guild. He was one of the Hollywood Ten. And had a tragic life, but he left a great book behind, The Theory and Technique of Screenwriting and Playwriting, that inspired me. And it was his thought that indeed we need great writers to shine a bright light into the dim corners of human nature and society in order to make somehow keep our lives livable. And I know working here in town, the tendency is, we understand why, to try to excuse what we do sometimes with the thought, well, it's just entertainment. It's never just entertainment. Every story expresses, bears a meaning. No matter if it's terribly told, badly written, wonderfully told, beautifully written, it doesn't matter, and everything in between. There is a meaning in every story. And that meaning is either adding to the quality of civilization or subtracting from it. Nothing is neutral. No story is innocent. Every story has an impact somewhere in the world on people's lives, and it's either a positive or a negative impact. I think it was Akiva that said that indeed, the telling of story for page, stage, or screen is the most powerful way to put ideas into the world today. I mean, who today is reading Kant or Spinoza if they don't have an exam to pass? Religion, for many of us, has become an evangelical joke. Science, with every new gizmo it creates, layers the world with yet another layer of toxicity. Cell phones being the worst of all, just separating us from our fellow human beings. We were meant to talk to people face to face, breathing the same air. That's how we were built. So where if science doesn't give us meaning, if religion and philosophy don't, where do people go to get an answer to Aristotle's great question, how should a human being lead their life? Where do they go? They go to the movies. God help them. They go to the movies trying to find sense, trying to understand in a comic way or a tragic way what it is to be a human being, to give themselves some guidance in this world. And story is the most powerful form of expressing meaning. And it always has been since we sat around the fire in caves. And this is why when the dictators get power, the first people they put in front of the firing squad are the writers. Why? Why the writers? I can tell you, it's not because they're afraid of the writers' ideas. Ideas do not threaten power. What they're afraid of is emotion. That is what intimidates dictators, because when people get upset, when people take it to the streets, things change. And story is is a meaningful emotional experience. It isn't an essay. It's the merging of meaning and emotion into a simultaneity that moves people to their heart and soul when it's good, beautiful, when it's great, and gets people up on their feet thinking, I've got to do something with my life. And so all I can ask you is this. When you wonderful writers are done with your piece, at the bottom of the, you're writing, you know, the end, fade out, and you look at what you've written, and you ask yourself, what does it mean? What does this story mean? And you pull that meaning out, and you come to understand the meaning of what you've written. Let me then pray that you would ask a second question. Not just what does my story mean, but do I believe it? Is this an honest statement of what I believe it is to be a human being? And if the answer is yes, you actually believe deeply in what you've written, then do everything humanly possible to get that to the world. But if you don't believe the truth of what you've written, this is why God gave us the delete key. Just highlight that whole damn thing and hit that button. And when it says, do you really want it? You say, fuck yes, and you do it again. Because in a world of lies and liars, we don't need writers adding to the slop. And so I just finally ended. I've just passed along to you the same thing, and anybody wants me to sign their book, I always write a little phrase with my signature and their name, and that phrase is, write the truth. And that is what I pray for all of you. Please, write the truth. Thank you so much.